Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, cats and kittens, dudes and dudettes, homies and peeps, look at the brilliant people with great taste all around you, and get ready for the most fun you've ever had in your life. Think about the most fun you've ever had in your life, and multiply it times 1,000, then double it, and add 5. Get goosebumps, look at the sky, let your hair stand on end and say, good God, I'm happy I made it. Welcome to the Happy Together Tour. Can I have a white one? I'm Sean Stevens, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Happy Together Tour. Our first act tonight had an amazing journey, selling millions of records on their way to number one. They became the real-life inspiration behind the Partridge Family. Even today, they personify the baby boom generation in all its extremes and eccentricities. They remain one of the most musically gifted American families to hit the top of the pop charts during that remarkable rise to fame and stardom of the late 60s. Coming all the way from Newport, Rhode Island to the Happy Together Tour, we are proud to present the Cousins.
Come here on Christmas and go on the subs for Christmas dinner.
It was a hoot.
So we're opening up this year. Welcome to this year's Happy Together Tour 2019. We're opening up. We're out here to get everybody excited. Is everybody excited?
Yeah.
All right, then we're going to get it going. It was 1967. It was the summer of love. And this is for all the flower girls out there.
I started singing the rain.
I love you.
14 and then Jim got a little freaked out, but 14's okay, right? 14's okay. It's called We Can Fly. Susan signed off it as a 9-year-old and picked it, and it was a big hit.
I made us millions.
The kids loved it, I guess. Called Indian Lake.
Where the air is fine, and the streets smell fine, and the
girl over there is my sister, Susan.
And that guy over there is our brother, Bob.
So this guy over there is Paulie.
There's a fourth cowsill. He drums for the Beach Boys. His name is John.
He has a real job.
We were nine, and now we're four.
The other five, hopefully, if things went well, they're in heaven.
Okay,
we had some rough and tumble brothers.
Your name is Bob, I think.
Anyway, Susan is born 10 years after me.
Oh, yeah, it's him.
Now, when she was born, I heard about it. Must have reached the third floor. And it was not a big event. There were six sons before her, so I got five brothers between me and Susan. It's not going to happen. So I met her when she was five. I did. At seven, she wanted to join the band.
Hey,
I really got to know that.
Did you know that? Yeah, we met when I was five. That's fine. Here's the deal. There's 7,000 boys running around this house. We watch a lot of television. They look like the guys on the TV. I'm three. I seen Robbie Douglas on TV from my three sons. I look to my left. There's Robbie Douglas. He looked just like him. His twin brother looked like Sandy from Flipper. And I'm walking around this house going, who and what and where am I? But there was one guy in the building. I didn't know the name of it. It was good because he often had food. His name is Paul.
I was the middle child. Thus, I'm in the middle still. I took care of the babies. It was Barry, John, and Susan, and I was their au pair. I was their Mr. French, so to speak.
Sweetheart.
I would get Barry and John up. I'd get them fed, and I'd put them in front of the TV. Then I'd go get Susan up. I'd change her diaper. I'd get her fed, and I'd put her in front of the TV.
Sorry, I'm sorry. We talked about this last night on the bus, and then I went to bed. We talked about not doing it anymore, and then I went to bed, and I thought, you know what? We'll keep that joke because I'm going to be changing Paul's diaper soon. Thank you, right? And it's not nearly as cute, all right? So, go ahead.
That all depends. I could have them on right now. You see the commercial, they're real stinky, you can wear skinny jeans without seeing the outside of the seat. They're a different color. So, anyway, after that.
Welcome to the family.
So, we're going to do another song because that's what they hired us for. And this is a song we needed to get on the tour because we had four hits, so you need five songs, so this is our fifth hit. You didn't know we did it, probably.
You'll be amazed that they had an eight-year-old sitting in the TV show.
All these people.
Stars.
My hair is a fright.
I was in the mirror this morning. Nose hairs, ear hair. They're growing, 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 and they won't stop.
Gross, gross, gross.
But what's really gross is this.
Agreed.
This one's not happening.
I'm hairy high and low.
Is one of the best blue-eyed soul groups of the mid-1960s. 4 top 10 records and 3 million sellers have become part of the musical legacy that they present tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, the Happy Together Tour is proud to present the Classics Forward.
Sweeter than Oh, made it all the way to number 2 on the national charts. Not number 1. Number 2. Gotta be careful which finger you use there. Yeah, okay. So, it had everything a song needs. Beautiful melody. Beautiful, heartwarming, heartbreaking lyrics like in every song needs. Number 2. So you might ask yourself, why not number 1? Go ahead, ask yourselves. I'm so glad you asked. Because of this little song. You're making me dizzy, my head is spinning like a whirlpool. I'm just teasing, that's a great song by Tyro and Dizzy. But it kept this next song out of the number 1 spot. Here's Traces of Love. Tonight and every night, we remember our lost friend, Mr. Dennis Yost. D.Y., we miss you.
Faded photographs, covered now with lines and creases, tickets torn in half. And pieces, traces of love long ago that didn't work out right. Traces of love, rhythms from her head, souvenirs of days to be. Pages from that old love letter, traces of love long ago that didn't work out right. Traces of love.
I think. Did I mention that song was number 2? point, but you know. Anyway, this next song we're gonna do for you came out in 1967, and it didn't go crazy. It just kind of hung around, and in late 1967, it started to climb the Billboard chart. So much so that they had to actually get the band back together. Everybody kind of gone their separate ways a little bit. And then in January 1968, this song became the first top 40 chart record for the Classics 4. And everybody knows why. It's because Love Is Kind of Crazy with a spooky little girl like you.
Buckingham. summer of 1967.
This is our 10th anniversary. Can you believe that? 10 years. Happy together. We've got a whole bunch of them. And I think this is our 23rd, if I remember correctly, show. First leg of the tour here. And we have about 700 to go. So that's, no, wait a minute. Numbers are off. It doesn't matter because we're having a great time out here. And thank you so much for making those first two songs we did, Big Hit Records for the Buckinghams. We appreciate it. Thank you. Back in 67, our good friend Jim Holvey wrote those songs, and he wrote Kind of a Drag and Susan also. And,
in the 60s.
In the 60s. You know, it was all about the same girl, too.
60s you know, people here?
Yeah.
Everybody, 60s people here? We were doing all sorts of crazy stuff in the 60s, right? You know, we used to do all that stuff and we had like acid and stuff like that. Now we do an acid.
You know, we were talking about the great TV shows back in the day, and we got to appear on a number of them. And, you know, before social media, we had these variety shows. You'd record a new song if you were lucky, you'd be invited on one of the great shows. Like, I'm sure you remember American Bandstand now. Well, there was one show that we were so excited to get out to the West Coast to perform on. We were so glad we were invited to perform on. I know you remember this, the Smothers Brothers Comedy Hour. Oh, yeah. We were like thrilled to be a part of it. What? set. We were thrilled to get out there and do the Smothers Brothers show. And we get out there and we go onto the stage and sound stage and do a little run through because they always want to make sure everything's working right. And we looked around, left, right, behind us, stage. And the whole stage was decorated with British flags hanging down. Jack, Union Jack. Yes. It's not hard to see, but that's bloody hell,
I wonder why that happened.
You see, they thought the Buckinghams were a British group. They thought we were from across the pond.
Well, look at the picture, Mo.
It's a little hard to see it, but it's there.
Beatle haircuts, right? Edwardian suits. The Buckinghams. So all I needed is a cup of tea with a little lemon and I would have been English. Didn't matter to me at all, this whole thing.
That didn't matter.
It was silly, I didn't care.
What?
Stage manager came up to us and went, "You guys did an absolutely marvelous sound check. It's time for dinner. Fish and chips." We're Italians from the west side of Chicago. Bring out the sausage and peppers. Bring out the pizza. Don't forget the cannoli, okay? Come on. Manny, take it easy with that. That song makes me cry.
Alright, this song made its debut, and thank you also very much for making this a big hit record for us. It was performed for the first time on the Smothers Brothers. It's a little song called Mercy, Mercy, Mercy. This is too much fun. We're going to do a song you're talking about great shows, I'll say this, you know, the epitome of success is if you were invited to perform on that same show that Elvis performed on, and the Beatles, and it was New York City, it was a really big show. You know what I'm talking about? Sure you do.
Really big shoe.
Really, that was a
really big shoe.
That was
a really, really big shoe. Big shoe. Really big shoe. Shaquille O'Neal big shoe. Really big shoe. Young boys from Chicagoland coming to the Southern Theater, Big Apple, to do the Southern Show. Before we bring our Buckingham Band, we're going to bring our little friend from across the seas, Chill Bill Chichi, on stage with the M from Russia, the Flying Lemons. You know, this song has a huge crush on the lead singer, Buckingham Band. Says it's a real snappy dresser, terrible kisser.
That's enough now. That's Sullivan, we're a ponytail now. He goes too far sometimes. All right, we're going to do this song. It was a debut on Ed Sullivan back in 68, and I want to thank you for making this a big hit for us, and we appreciate it. I hope you remember a little song called Susan. Thank you. Mention this guy here because, you know, we're the two old guys, and started the band back in the day, you know.
What do you say, we're two what?
Well,
two old guys?
Two original Bucking Hams, yes we are. Nick Fortuna on the bass and vocals. This song, by February of 1967, went up the charts, became the number one record and number two, And we appreciate it so much. Not the Monkees, right off the number one spot. And we took over. Little song, bro.
Including the Beatles. His greatest hits album today remains one of CBS Records' biggest-selling record albums in the label's history. He performed a command performance at the White House for Prince Charles by special invitation of the President, and the Happy Together Tour is proud to present, by special invitation, Gary Puckett.
I know you want it. I know you're having a good time because I've been standing right at the side of the stage over there watching all my friends as they do their shows. I'm a fan just like you. I love the music. It's just a pleasure. It's an honor to be on this stage with all of my friends. Here's 1969. Gary Buckley. Hi. Once again, sorry to see you. And that was an investment in those days, you know what I mean? Yeah, so Anyway, it now is going on 17 million copies. Just because of you. So thank you very much. Here's my favorite woman. Woman, have you got two? Do you mind singing with me, please?
The pudding is made up.
band that started in 1968. His voice would be one of the most popular voices in music history. For 5 years, no group had more top 10 hits or sold more concert tickets. And during this period, Three Dog Night was undoubtedly the most popular band in America, with 21 consecutive top 40 hits and 12 straight gold LPs. By late 1975, they had sold nearly 50 million records. And now the show goes on. The band's records continue to sell in great numbers, and he receives regular airplay on radio stations around the world. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great joy that we introduce Chuck Negron.
Whiskey, roll, sugar, tea.
he's also going to help us.
Oh, thank you, sweetie. That's a girl.
this June I turned 77.
Thank you.
1960s themselves, our next act was a once-in-a-lifetime happening. A too-good-to-be-true magical blend of melody, harmony, and humor that spoke to a generation. There's something star-crossed about their music, and their sound is iconic, capturing the true spirit of the American 1960s. Angelic harmonies and intoxicating choruses that delivered the most innocent psychedelia that California ever created. For 5 years of hits and great memories for 40 more, their legacy grows stronger every time their name gets mentioned. Today, the happy, uplifting sound continues to be a part of everything possible. Movies, television shows, promos, and commercials. They have sold over 40 million records worldwide, and we are honored to present the humor, the optimism, the shimmering harmonies, and legendary melodies of my friends, the Turtles.
Oh, the second time I've brought the tambourine this whole summer. So it was a very special night for me and for you. Thank you. How are you doing? It's a great show, isn't it? About is this show goes back now 10 full years. It's our 10th anniversary tour, as we're calling it. I keep hearing young angels, and I'm not going to say anything. We had this band in high school. It was a surfing band from the Southern California South Bay of Manhattan Beach. And we made a record. The record did very well. And here we are 175 years later. And we really enjoy the fact that you're all enjoying Oldies again. They make a cycle and we're in the middle of it. So we made this record, our little band, and it got played on the radio in Southern California and ended up being a top 10 record. And sent us on our very first tour of the United States. We went to New York City. It wasn't exactly a big tour. It was a New York City tour. And we played at a really adventurous nightclub in the middle of downtown Manhattan. It was a small place. It was called The Phone. That sounded wrong. It was a big club, but it was called The Phone Booth. And that night, Bob Dylan came down to meet us and hear us because we were singing his song as our record, It Ain't Me, Babe. And he sat through the whole show, didn't throw a thing. And he met us after the show, and we walked through a line like we were meeting the Queen. And Bob looked up and said, that's a really good song you guys are playing at the end of the show. I think you should record it. I think it could be a number one record. And he didn't even realize that he had written the song. But we performed it then, as we will tonight, and we'd love you to join us. Everybody's going to sing one word. Let me hear you say, no, no, no. This should be easy for the wives in the audience. I know it was for our five. I had one. Made as many hits as you had one. So here it is, the song It Ain't Me, Babe, performed by the Turtles in 1965.
Who's never weak, always strong.
Miller woke before dawn. He put his Skechers on. He took a place from the ancient gallery.
Thank you.
Roots tour as a 10-year anniversary. It makes you kind of look back. Many of us have been with the show for almost 14 years as we took it out several years even before we called it Happy Together. It was a really dumb thing not to do. But we're using Happy Together through all of the stuff. We go online. We actually have a CD available tonight only. We sell at our shows. It's a CD with all of the artists performing six or seven songs from the past few years, and we're going to keep issuing these every year. So take a look at it on your way out. I want you to meet a great singer, songwriter, producer. He produced the great Barry Manilow. He made a great name for himself, and he's a great guy to be out on tour with. This is a great musician and singer, and I want you to say hello to Ron Dante. Ron Dante.
Hey, everybody.
I'm just so happy to be singing these great turtle songs. But 3 years ago, I was on the tour as the opening act with my own group called the Archies, right? This is our 50th anniversary of our biggest hit. It was the number one song of 1969, and we're going to sing it for you. You all know it. It's my hit, Sugar Sugar. Chris Camilleri.
generator. What the hell am I talking about? Over here, keyboards, upstate New York's home, that's right, somewhere between Canandaigua and Albany. I don't know what Canandaigua is. It was a little place years ago to buy pot. So if you go up there now, you'll see people like with pictures of me saying, "Have you seen this man?" Over here on the keyboards, the great Manny Focarazzo. Manny Focarazzo. Over here on the lead guitar, our musical director. What does that mean? I'm not really sure, but I like the title. It looks good, MD. So if you don't get a job playing guitar, you might be able to pass yourself off as a doctor. As musical director, it's his job to hire the musicians. It's his job to make sure that they learn the material correctly. It's his job to sing, play, and do all the quick...
Make you coffee in the morning.
Make me coffee. He's a great coffee maker, and I'm usually not very awake, but let's not stop there. Let's introduce a man who has played guitar with the great Jack Bruce from the group The Cream. He worked with the great John Entwistle. 10 years he played guitar with John Entwistle of The Who, and this year he has signed a new agreement to make records with a group from London that will be touring soon, so make sure you make reservations. It's a band called The Yardbirds.
Thank you.
been waiting all night to sing this next song. You know it, the band knows it. Why don't we all just get up and sing Happy Together tonight? Godfrey, hit it!
Thank you. our club, Baldwin Instituto!
Happy Together Tour 2020. Thanks for coming. Good night, everybody.